If you haven't heard it already, this is Taylor Swift's new album, Evermore, and the first song on it titled Willow. Hi, my name is Shrinija Dandibhotla, and welcome to The Windy Hill, Methacton's student news site. Music is an important aspect of pop culture in the world around us today, and so if you are interested in listening to a full music album review on Evermore, the latest release by the award-winning artist Taylor Swift, then keep on listening. Please keep in mind that I will be sharing my thoughts and opinions on the album, and they are not intended to malign anyone or anything. So I'd like to start off with some background information and my overall thoughts on the album, Evermore. It is said to be a sister album to Folklore, an album Taylor Swift released back in July of 2020. Both albums are classified as alternative or indie, which is a big shift from her prior music, considering that many of her past number one albums and songs have been pop with hints of country. I believe it was a risky but rewarding move on her part to totally change up her music because her audience was definitely not expecting it. But regardless, I enjoy listening to both albums because of their chill vibe. Evermore is a very simple album, with less production and only a few instruments, making it sound very raw and acoustic-like, similar to Folklore. What really hit home with both of these albums was the lyrics and the diaristic or narrative-like stories that Taylor Swift portrayed with some of the songs. For example, on Evermore, there is a song called Nobody, No Crime, and Taylor Swift describes a situation between a character named Esty and her husband, and she incorporates her own feelings into those characters. This new approach to songwriting is what really stood out to me, and it was very evident that both albums were written in similar mindsets and approaches. Although both albums are beautifully written, I personally found myself liking Evermore more than Folklore because some of the melodies weren't as monotone and had hints of country and pop fused into them. And as crazy as it sounds, normally we think that some albums and some songs are overproduced, but for her albums, and Evermore and Folklore, they all had this element of almost sounding like an acoustic demo that hadn't been produced yet. So these elements added more weight and depth to these songs. My favorite songs are Willow, Champagne Problems, Gold Rush, and Nobody, No Crime on Evermore. Some of the drawbacks and things that I didn't like about this album were that it's not for everyone and it's not for every situation either. The lyrics were much deeper and warmer in tonality, but also darker at the same time. And it might have been much harder to relate to some of the situations because the writing was almost country-like, where it was so descriptive and detailed and so specific to one situation that it's hard to generalize. Second thing, the minimalistic, chill vibe that she projected was very cool initially for many of the songs, but it also got redundant, and the whole acoustic vibe and feeling kind of diminished as you kept listening to the album. To sum this up in brief, I really, really enjoyed Taylor Swift's new album, Evermore. It wasn't about the melodies or the types of songs, but mostly focused on the lyrics, which was beautifully presented, and her artistry and creativity truly shined within these songs. Although I'm unsure as to how sustainable this type of music will be for her in the future and how many albums she can make like this, I truly feel like these are lyrical masterpieces that presented her artistry in such a different way that they haven't been before. And even if these albums, especially Evermore, isn't as successful as her previous ones, I'm sure that her audience can connect and relate to her on those deeper emotions. So that's a wrap for this podcast and for this music review on Taylor Swift's new music on the album Evermore. Please be sure to leave a comment as to what you think about this album and how your opinions are similar or different from mine. And yeah, thank you so much for tuning in to Methacton student news site, The Windy Hill.